Hey guys, welcome back to Far Cry New Dawn. On the last episode, we most definitely ended off with a cliffhanger. We took this incredibly ominous, just disturbing journey up the river, all the way up Hope County, until we finally became face to face with the one and only Joseph Seed. And not just any Joseph Seed, old man Joseph Seed. So he talked some heebie-jeebies to us. And now we are going to be picking up right where we left off in the last episode, where we have to follow him and see what the hell he wants from us. All right, Joseph.
After God's cleansing fire, I saw the journey he had laid out before us. And I knew what was required when we set foot on our new Eden. When humanity emerged, I gathered my flock and set them on a new path. A rejection of everything connected to the old world. The creation of a new society. Living off the land. Taking only what was needed.
Yeah, you better stare straight the fuck ahead, Joseph.
I despaired. And in that despair, I found how selfish. This tree.
That tree?
Its fruit a gift from God, which gave my family the strength to endure through the famine and the pestilence.
Okay.
New Eden thrived. We created a paradise on Earth. But it did not last.
Go figure.
This plague of locusts saw to that.
Are we the locusts?
These highwaymen embody everything God has instructed us to forsake.
Oh, so you hate the highwaymen too. Wow, the enemy of my enemy is my friend type of shit, huh?
You are different. I believe your soul is worthy.
Just let it be known, Joseph, if I get a chance to kill you, it's going down. What in the world? Got some hieroglyphics up here? This looks like it used to be a dam. Yeah, it most definitely did. Okay. What in the world? So I wonder what makes this tree so different. I wonder if it was, I don't know, it had bliss infused into it, so that's what makes it so vibrant? I don't know. It's a gorgeous tree, I will say that. It just makes it weird that, you know, you got Joseph. Looking like he's about to make sweet love to it.
This is the help that you've been seeking.
Is that an apple tree? Of course it is. Why would it be anything else than something about religion? Interesting.
My family through the darkest time. First time that I partook of this gift, I was confronted by a ravenous beast. It was my soul. And in that moment, I knew that in order to be worthy of God's gift, I had to slay that beast. I had to cleanse my soul. Because if I did not, I knew that that beast would consume me. This is God's test. And your soul.
I don't know if I really want to eat this apple. Okay, we're eating the apple. Oh, God.
Go. Kill the beast.
What? What the hell is in this apple, Joseph? More drugs, right? Of course. We should know better by now, man. These people are all on drugs.
If your soul is pure, you are the shepherd sent by God, and I can return from my exile. Our miracle allowed us to survive, but its gifts are not unconditional. It nourishes what is in a person's soul. But if that soul is corrupt, the miracle extracts a terrible price.
This game does such a phenomenal job at making you think, though.
Or you will not survive.
So now we have a completely different weapon. Oh, what? Where? Okay, okay. This is our only weapon.
Confront your beast where it is weakest.
Oh, dude, what am I supposed to do to beat this thing, man? I'm playing Ring Around the Rosy with the bear, dude. No! I need to hit it on his belly or something?
Rises, strike true.
Yep, yep. You can see the underneath it. I'm trying. There we go. There we go. What's happening? Oh, fucking hell, dude. It's dark now. It wasn't creepy enough, but now we're gonna do this, huh? This is what we're doing? Okay, sharpshooter, baby. Sharpshooter. This is so intense.
The heart of your sin.
Right in your belly, bitch. Use a med kit. Heal up, heal up, heal up, heal up. What am I supposed to do to beat this thing? Nice. Oh, Joseph!
Cleanse your soul.
Okay.
Unleash the power.
Why am I on fire? Why the fuck am I on fire? What the hell are we doing? Ah! Bitch! Bitch! I'm gonna whoop your foe! Nope, 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 nope. Bitch! Bitch! Right in the asshole! Did we do it? Oh my God, did you see?
That is why.
Did you see that thing on the ground?
There are those who must not be allowed to partake of this miracle. Even if I love them. Even if they are of my family. Sin is a beast we cannot be.
It makes it even creepier that he just whispers everything like he's 2 inches to your left, whispering in your ear. That was so fucking loud.
You will be the shepherd of my people.
I love how I have no choice in any of this. I'm just like willingly getting brainwashed, even though I know what he's doing.
Come with me to New Eden.
Oh no, this is not what Ethan wanted. Well, this is gonna cause trouble in paradise for him.
Our future depends on adherence to my strictures. We can no longer hope for Joseph to save us.
Oh, they're about to freak the fuck out.
He is not coming back.
Ah!
We must put him out of our minds and...
That's a bad timing for you to be saying that, Father.
Ethan. Father?
Father.
Where have you been? Our land is under siege, our people threatened. You disappeared. You left us when we needed you most. Why?
To hear God's plan, my son. To hear God's plan.
Yeah, we heard you the first time, you crazy fuck.
My children. I know that you have suffered. And I know that you are afraid. I have been gone from you for a very long time. But you were not abandoned. God spoke to me, and he has shown me a path out of this darkness. We will no longer hide behind these walls. We will no longer simply hope that this plague of locusts leaves us in peace. The time to fight is now. And God has sent us his sword. Here.
Why are you pointing at me, Joseph?
God has tested their soul, and it is just, and it is pure. And I stand here before you to bear witness that this outsider is our shepherd.
Father!
And together, we will battle against the hordes outside our gates, and together we will march towards the future that God has promised us.
Look at all his new scars as well.
You abandoned me. You abandoned us. Without a word, without instructions, leaving me to lead as best I could. And now, you return. As if descended from the clouds and presumed to lead?
Yes.
I am the leader here.
Joseph is our leader.
New Eden follows me!
We stand behind the Father.
Son, I know you've carried a heavy burden in my absence. I understand that. This is God's will.
Hey, don't look at me like that, bro.
Sacrifice that which we want.
I don't want to do this any more than you do.
What have you ever sacrificed?
Someday you will see the light. I promise. Come. Let us all go together. We have much work to do.
So my guess is we're going to end up taking out the highwaymen with New Eden, and then after that, it's going to be all rain on trying to take out Joseph. But I mean, there's got to be some kind of information that comes forth for why we would want to kill Joseph. Right now, our character has no reason to, I mean, other than Joseph being just inherently, obviously psychotic, we have no real reason to want to harm Joseph. Like I said earlier, the enemy
already
of my enemy
my chosen, fight the
is my friend.
And throughout the long nights, now I will ask them to find the strength to fight in the day as well. Your friend should make good use of the distraction and act quickly. My family cannot fight forever. As for you, remember God's gift. What you have experienced so far is just a taste of God's power. Do not waste it. I will also give leave for my judge to follow you. They speak only one language, that of violence. In this, they will serve you well. Before you can be our shepherd, you must be our sword. Go and make the land safe for all who wish to live in
peace. I want to know who this is. This guy is everywhere. Everywhere, but we have no idea who he is. Joseph's secret completed. The judge. Open in roster. So now we can fight with him? Who is the judge, though? That's gotta be Peaches, right?
Whatever happens, keep in mind our gift is precious.
Okay, well, what now? Let's go to our map. do we have anything that we could really do? I mean, we could go back to prosperity, but it doesn't seem like we really have much to do. Oy. I'm not sure. I don't know if we can upgrade our perks probably while we buy time, but I would assume that something else would pop up after that, right? Like, you gotta give me something to do. New challenges acquired. Do we have to accept these? Is this how this works? No, okay, I have no idea. All right, that's cool. Okay. You left me not knowing what to do or where to go. They do a good job of that in this game, but we do have 15 perk points available. And okay, so we got all these new perks. Leap of faith, press space while in midair for additional jump height. So we get a double jump? Ghost, hold C to temporarily become much harder to detect by humans. Consumes Eden's gift. So we almost have like a extraterrestrial power about us. So we gotta choose which one we want. Eden's touch. Takedowns replenish Eden's gift and health. That one doesn't sound as cool. Increases the regeneration rate of Eden's gift. So I think what I wanna do is I wanna do this, the double jump, and then I also wanna do this. I wanna, you know, the regeneration rate of it is gonna help, and then the double jump. That's fucking cool. Nobody like, okay. Don't mind me, dude. I'm just doing some weird shit. Oh my god. Hey, oppa.
You might be the answer to our
problem. I could do this all day, dude. Okay, but that doesn't help us get on with the story. Okay, focus up here. Focus up. What do I do? I mean, what I really want to do, I think the next thing that I really want to work towards is I really want to get level 3 weapons in the workbench. So I know I'm going to need quite a bit of ethanol. So how much ethanol do we have right now? We have 143. I wonder if I can go do this outpost and maybe scavenge the rest. If I can get enough ethanol that we can upgrade a workbench and get some level 3 weapons, because we need it. We need it with how fast we're trying to progress in this story. So let's go get our obligatory action shoot 'em up part of the story into the game, or into today's episode. And oh, are you? Okay, you're with me.
You've done nice work up north, Captain.
Oh.
Come on back. We'll talk over what we can do here in prosperity.
Okay, there we go. So we're gonna need to upgrade prosperity again. So us doing this and getting ethanol is gonna almost be necessary. Absolutely necessary. For the father! I don't know where this crazy man went. Blind shot, imagine. So that means I'm gonna have to do quite a bit of grinding off camera, I would presume, in order to get the resources necessary to be able to upgrade prosperity. There's so many times in this game, I know, like, this is just such an ADHD moment where, like, you know, get to the top, to the summit of the hill. But the landscaping in this game is so gorgeous. I thought that same way in Far Cry 5. But, I don't know, something about this game, the way it looks so barren and war-torn, I mean, because it did get hit by a nuke, It's beautiful in its own right. I really enjoy that. Okay, there's a plane flying up ahead. And we have a supply drop we need to go get. So let's do this. This will probably get us about 30 to 40 ethanol. Which, I mean, we need right now, since we're trying to upgrade prosperity, we need every little bit that we can. And this is the other thing that sucks, is normally I'm trying to get through this story right now, but normally I'd be doing all sorts of stuff off camera by now, where I probably have so much ethanol and stuff to get that we could probably already upgrade prosperity, but we don't, and that's okay. Yeah, we got 40 ethanol. I don't know if we have a wingsuit. I don't think we do yet, but we can use this zip line, and that'll pretty much put us right where we need to go. So Let's liberate the outpost, and we need to do it without being detected. I'm not even necessarily worried about the alarms. I mean, I am. Don't get me wrong. But I'm more worried about not being detected. Because that gets us an extra 25 ethanol. And the more we do that with the more difficult outposts, the more we get from it. So the hardest part is just trying to find all the enemies. I almost whiffed there. We're going to reload. Because we only got a four ammo capacity in this. See, I just don't know where the enemies are. I know they're down here somewhere. But I don't want to overexpose myself and then not be able to see them, right? I need them to be marked. I think I see one over there. Yep. Good shot, baby. I just got detected from over that direction. But where? Oh, I see her up there. Where's the resties? No! I fucked that up so bad, man. I should have known better. I did know better, but I decided to just keep doing what I was doing. All right, well, 125 ethanol either way, and I think that should... I hope that gives us enough. I really do. If not, I can always scavenge and reset it to compensate for the difference. Unless I need to save my ethanol to upgrade. I don't remember if I need mass amounts of ethanol to upgrade prosperity, but... let's go back. I know we're probably going to need to rescue another specialist, so my guess would be we'll probably have to travel north to be able to do that. Hey. We need to talk to Thomas Rush first, so let's go ahead and do that.
Did it.
I did
glad
do it.
Back, Captain. You got Joseph Seed on our side.
Yeah, that sounds weird to say out loud.
Too high a price. There's something different about you. You've changed. But now the New Eden's attacking the Highwaymen. The twins are fighting a war on two fronts. We need to take advantage of this.
I agree.
We've done good work in prosperity, but it's still not enough. We need more specialists. We need to invest some ethanol in our facilities.
Okay.
That's the key to getting prosperity back up and running again. Once this place is at its peak, we'll be in a good spot to really take the fight to Mickey and Lou.
Yeah, we haven't seen them in a little while.
I'm gonna do some recon. See if we can't get a foothold deeper in their territory. I'll meet you back here once you're done.
Okay. All right. I don't know if I necessarily like the whole rescue all specialist. Oh, we have to rescue all specialists and upgrade facilities? Oh, so I'm about to do a ton of grinding off camera. Son of a bitch, dude. Oh man, upgrade. We have to upgrade 7 more facilities. That's kind of a lazy mechanic. But I guess I understand. I mean, some of the specialists are kind of cool, I will say. So doing their missions could actually be really nice. And we need 500 ethanol. I don't even know if... Oh, dude, we need exactly 200. So if we scavenge that, we'll scavenge that. We'll scavenge this. We'll scavenge the other two that we've already done, and hopefully that'll give us 500, and then we can upgrade to workbench level 3. And I believe that's the max level of the workbench, but I'm not sure. Scavenge that. Yep, stay nearby my current location. Well, that makes me think that taking on Mickey and Lou, if we have to upgrade prosperity to its fullest before we go after them, that we're not far off from being done. Because there's no way you would have us do that or want us to do that if we weren't getting somewhat close to the end. So I assume we're going to finish up prosperity, I'm gonna have to grind off camera, which will be fine for me because I love exploring this world and playing this game. And so I'll do all that off camera, and then we'll probably do one more specialist mission today. And then we'll get everything we need to upgrade everything, and then we'll take out Mickey and Lou. I don't know if it's all in one mission or separately, and then after that, who the hell knows? But I think this did give us enough. 508, yes. Yes, 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 yes. We need more fire power big time. Oh, we don't even have it max. We still need... Okay, we still need 2 of 3. Or we still need 3 of 3. We're at 2 of 3.
Thanks for giving me the tools for success.
Okay, well, can I... Yes, I can. Let's see what new weapons we can craft, huh? Ooh, that is some sweet looking melee weapons, though. Ooh. Okay, so we need some gears in order to get that. We already have the vector. But is it really any better than what we already have? That's the thing that I don't know. And then the AK. We already know the AK is absolutely disgusting. We don't have enough for some of these. Oh, man. This is tough. This is really tough. I would like to have that pistol because I feel like that pistol is going to be really good. We already have the vector, so I'm not all that worried about it, but I would like a more powerful suppressed long-range gun. But then there's also the AK for when we want to burp burp. Can we craft both? I don't know if we'll have enough. I don't think we will. I'm going to have to choose. I tell you what, I think I'm going to craft the AK. Yeah, I think I'm going to craft the AK. I'm going to replace the vector. Okay. All right. So now we have to make the decision of what specialists are we going to do next. I feel like it would only make sense to do Nick and Sharky in the same one. And we also have Erwin Small as a story mission. Let's go see Celine. Okay, so it's got to be in here. I don't know what exactly we're trying to do, because it doesn't really say. It's just radio silent. But I assume we got to do something. That looks like a lady we should talk to. Are you Celine? Yes, you are.
Yo, dude, you got, like, springy gams? Good legs?
No.
Oh my god, my dude. I am my dude. The worst real life calm down that's ever graced the freaking planet right now. I grow these, herbs. You know, herbs. Don't ask me what kind, it's the kind that work, okay? That
kind.
I trek around here with a field kit and, it fell. It fell just over the lip of this weird pavement hole. It's got, like, a year's worth of homegrown stuff in there. That kit saved me from like 8 deficiencies and 4 infections in the past 6 months alone. I can recultivate this stuff, sure, but like, honestly, between you and me, my dude, that shit down there is my freaking lifeline. I won't last till the next harvest, next month without it. People die from like the dumbest shit these days. Get me my kit, and I'll keep you and your people ticking. So you can die from violence like your God intended, instead of like stepping on a nail.
I respect that. Okay. Deep dive story mission. Retrieve the field kit. Why would I ever think it would be easy? Oh god, there's fish. I hope there's no demon fish.
Oh, hairy titties. I don't see a way back up, my pal. See if you can find some
hairy titties. Oh my god, we're in the old bunker. I wonder whose bunker we're in. Are we in John's? Yeah, we're in John's. Okay. Oh, man. This is creepy. I never thought we'd actually come back here. Okay. Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
We should get back to the main hole.
Yeah. Working on it. We also have to get your kit, though. So I guess we have to do that while the water's rising, right? And now what? We wait? Oh, we have to probably wait till it raises up to get to this, and then do the same thing, and then keep on, keep on, keep on, keep on, it kind of looks like. There's no way you're gonna make me do this 5 times, right? No way. I refuse to believe that. I also refuse to believe that there's nothing inhabiting this bunker.
Okay, now the water not rising is a problem. Needs to keep rising. You need to keep flooding the place. Take a look around.
Don't make me shoot dogs. Why? Why? I don't want to do that. I don't want to do it. I don't care if they're... I don't care if they're deranged. I'm so sorry. Oh, they didn't know any better. They were just scared. Man. How exactly do we plan on raising this bitch? Well, I definitely want to crack this lock. The titanium seems like it is rather difficult to come by. I guess we're gonna have to swim under there. That seems like it's gonna be our only way. Okay. Oh boy. Oh boy. We gotta move. We gotta move.
Whatever you do, don't panic. I'm using up all the panic around here.
I'm panicking.
You're gonna use up all the oxygen in your blood if you panic. Then you double drown. It's human body basics.
I'm already feel like that's happening. Oh my lord. I love how we just like know we're going the right way, right? All right, sick.
Okay, whatever squeaky magic you did before, you have to do it again. Twist some knobs or jiggle some doohickeys to build up the pressure.
No. Okay, so there's water coming out of it. We need to interact with it. Because we need to build up the pressure. Right? Or does it need to be the exact opposite? Okay, maybe we need to be the exact opposite. No. What else is there? What do you mean? Is there another one I'm missing over here somewhere? No. Well, what the fuck? Oh, open every in valve and close every out valve. Okay, so that's an in. Open. No, we need to close that. That's an out. And then this? And then that. There we go. Okay. Well, now we wait. Oh God, this shit is okay. Okay. Okay, this isn't cool anymore. This isn't cool anymore. This is really fucking freaky.
So this is kinda like
there's
the
a dead rat. Not
water,
a dead rat.
There's crocodiles.
Gonna
I'm just saying, okay? I'm just saying.
Did you say fucking crocodiles? My last name's not Dundee. I'm not cut out for this shit. Black horse silo. I just noticed that. Interesting. Can my guy swim a little bit faster? You're gonna die, buddy. Let's go. Boom. Nice.
Yo, you just need a little more water. Try out the ladder.
Oh my lord, this better be the last time I do this shit.
Snakes are no fun. They have no chill at all. Watch your treads down there.
Snakes! Listen, Celine, what in the fuck do you have me doing? Offer some weed? That's what's going on? You're talking about snakes? Gosh damn it. They better reward me with the damn safe. You got me worried about nuclear snakes that have mutated under nuclear radiation. Are you serious? Make sure we loot up everything. Oh man. Was this where John Seed had us captive? I think it is, where he was torturing us. I'm not sure though. Cult note, I don't care. I see a snake. There's a snake in my boots. I hear another one of them slippy, slimy bastards. You thought, bitch. Hey, man, listen. Are you dead? Oh, thank God. Oh, listen, bro. I'm already on edge. You got creepy, ominous music going in the background. I'm in an abandoned bunker. And now I got crocodiles that can come out of nowhere and try to bite my nuts off. That's not okay. I'm on edge. And you got me swimming towards something. Yeah, something's gonna happen. I don't wanna look, dude. This is like classic horror film shit. Oh, God. Oh, God. Hey, I appreciate the compliment on my ass. Thank you. We're moving and grooving. Back the way we came.
Listen, you are such a superhero right now. A super freaky fitness genius. You can do it. I believe in you.
You give me some weird vibes.
Holy tit feathers. You made it.
Tit feathers.
Get my kit, okay? Get my field kit. Don't forget, okay? Please go get it.
Yeah, we got you. I don't know why there's this intense-ass music playing. The intense part's kind of already over. We'll be able to get her kit, and then we can climb to the ladder over there. Got it. Got it good. Come on. Let me grab her, this lady's drugs. Let me grab her weed. It's a big-ass bag of weed.
I love you. I fucking love you. I'm gonna keep living. No death for me. No death for you. We get to keep tripping through the landscape.
Huh. I stand to settle down. Stop freezing my tits off in the wilderness. Oh, my sweet baby.
She is kind of cute, though, in a weird, unhygienic way.
So much easier. Now I can itch my bug bites and get them infected without dropping dead a month later. Thank you, for real. I've been meaning to, like, help people instead of collecting roots like a dirt hoarder and junk, so you mind if I run with you? I can set up my lab in your home camp garden or whatever, and I can help you boost your immune systems and get you feeling real good. A constitution and junk. I'll just set up my stuff there now, yeah? Yeah, I'm going now. Gonna settle in. Thanks again, my dude.
All right, my dude. Bye. All right, deep dive completed. Plus one specialist in prosperity. Why do y'all look like you're having a conversation? This guy doesn't fucking talk. I don't even know where he's at. He just appears out of the shadows at random. Okay, so... oh, do I want to try a level 3 outpost since we have level 3 guns? I don't know if that's the best idea. Maybe that's how we end the episode, though. That would be kind of cool, yeah? Let's try it. We get 300 ethanol for it, too, which, I mean, we kind of desperately need. I don't know. Oh, man, but if we could do this undetected... if we could do this undetected, we would get so much ethanol. Man, they are not fucking around here. They are really not fucking around here. Oh my god, they have dogs. Okay. All right, we're not meant to do that shit. Ain't no way.
I've seen their trophy.
I don't know exactly which one I would want to do. The infirmary would be nice. Hey, Celine, how are you, weird lady? We need 500 for that. Explosive lab is cool and all.
Everyone in the valley knows how you defended those walls.
Healing garden, we can upgrade to level 2. But cartography, we don't even have level 1, so maybe we can upgrade a couple things here. If they're 75 apiece and we haven't upgraded them yet, we might be able to do one more.
You're a hometown hero now.
Or we can upgrade this to level 2. Ooh, actually, we should probably do the garage.
New Eden doesn't have a miracle. They have
or
a
what does this do? Guns for higher rank 2, gun for higher rank. Or guns for higher rank 1, now guns for higher rank 2. I like that. That'll actually help us a lot. That explains why our help and our characters sucked ass. Yeah, get to work, man. Do some more pull-ups. Put the work in. All right, guys. As the sun is setting on New... I almost said New Eden. Oh, man. As the sun is setting on the new Hope County here in Prosperity, so is the sun setting in this episode. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you guys did, make sure to leave a like before you guys go. Stay awesome. Stay yourself. And I will see you guys in the next episode, okay? Peace out, YouTube.